Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today I'm going to show you how to fix HTTP error 431. HTTP status codes like the 431 error can be frustrating because they get in the way of the website that you want to interact with, or it's getting in the way of your customers visiting your site. Thankfully, the error code provides you with the information that you need to fix it in the form of those three numbers, 431. In this video, you'll learn what this specific error means and what some of the common causes are. Then, we'll share four troubleshooting steps that you can follow to fix the problem, whether you're experiencing it on someone else's website or your own website. Before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what is the HTTP error 431? Before we can talk about the HTTP error 431 specifically, we first need to talk about what HTTP is and where these errors come from. There are tons of different status codes. Some HTTP status codes indicate that everything is functioning normally. However, many HTTP status codes indicate some type of error. As you can probably guess, the HTTP 431 message is one of the error codes. The number 431 indicates the specific HTTP error, which is request header fields too large. Essentially, this means that the HTTP request that your browser is making to the server is too large, or another way of phrasing it is that the request is too long. This can happen because the total size of the request headers is too large, or it can happen because a single header field is too large. Because your browser is making a request that is too large or long, the server drops, denies the request instead of delivering the HTTP response that your browser was expecting. Because your browser doesn't receive the needed response, it's unable to render the website and shows the HTTP error 431 message instead. In general, HTTP error codes can indicate a problem in two different areas. On the server side, there's something going wrong in the web server that's triggering the error code. On the client side, there's something going wrong in the web browser that's triggering the error. The HTTP error 431 is a client-side HTTP error. That means the cause of the problem is somewhere in your web browser because your web browser is the one making the request with large headers. That also means that you'll need to apply most fixes by adjusting your web browser. However, the root cause isn't always your browser's fault. Sometimes the way the website is coded can cause your browser to make large requests. Typically, the HTTP error 431 is caused by issues with cookies, long refer URLs, or just the total size of the request headers. If you're trying to visit someone else's website, you can try to eliminate these causes by adjusting your web browser. If you have your own website and you're trying to diagnose why your site's visitors are seeing the HTTP error 431, you might need to dig into your site's code to make it less likely to cause your site's visitors to have large requests. For example, you might need to adjust how your site uses cookies in visitors' browsers or configure your server to accept larger requests. Now that you know what the HTTP error 431 request header fields too large message means and some of its causes, let's get into how you can fix this error. Pretty much all websites use cookies to identify and store information about individual users. For example, if you log into a website, that website will use a cookie to remember that you're logged in so that you don't need to log in again every single time you visit. To learn more about cookies, check out our guide to cookies and PHP sessions. However, if there are too many cookies, that can lead to large HTTP request headers, which can trigger the HTTP error 431 request header fields too large message. One common fix, therefore, is to clear the cookies for the site where you're experiencing the issues. Most popular browsers make this pretty easy to do. Remember, if you clear your cookies, you will be logged out of every website for which you clear cookies. If you clear all your browser's cookies, that means you'll be logged out of every single website. For that reason, we recommend starting with the targeted approach of only clearing cookies for the specific site where you're experiencing the problems. If that doesn't work, then you can try fully clearing your browser's cookies. Here's how to clear browser cookies in Chrome. Enter the following in your browser address bar. Search for the URL of the site where you're experiencing issues. Then click the trash can icon to delete all of the cookies and site data for that site. This basic method should also work for other Chromium-based web browsers such as Brave, Edge, Vivaldi, Opera, and others. However, you'll need to go through the settings area rather than pasting in the URL. To clear cookies for a specific site in Safari, follow these instructions. Open the Preferences area. Select the Privacy tab. Click Manage Website Data. Search for and select the site where you're experiencing issues. And click the Remove button once you've selected the site. To clear cookies for a specific site in Firefox, follow these instructions. Enter the following in your Firefox browser address bar. Scroll down and find the Cookies and Site Data section. Click the Manage Data button in that section. Search for and select the site where you're experiencing issues. Then click the Remove Selected button once you've selected the site. Trying to visit a site using URLs with long query parameters can also trigger the HTTP error 431. Query parameters are the part of a URL that comes after the main URL. They're used to pass additional information to the server, but they aren't actually required to access the page in most cases. For example, many sites use UTM parameters to track conversions. Here's an example of a base URL with some additional query parameters. To see if this is the problem, delete the question mark and everything that comes after it. Then try revisiting the newly cleaned URL and see if the error disappears. These next two tips won't help if you're experiencing the error on someone else's website. But if you're experiencing the error on your own site, or if your visitors are complaining of experiencing the error, then these tips can help address the root cause. The first option is to dig into your site's code and check if your code is generating large request headers. That is, whether your code is forcing visitors' browsers to send large requests. These errors are specifically common when working with JavaScript. If you check out Stack Overflow, you'll see that most of the people experiencing this error are using technologies such as AngularJS, React, Node.js, and more. For example, your Node.js app could be asking for more information than is needed, which is generating unnecessarily large request headers. Similarly, remember that spaces in your code count toward the size of the request, so that can be another invisible source of large requests. In some cases, you can also adjust the maximum request size at the server level by editing your server's configuration code. For example, if you're using React, you can adjust the max header size in the package.json file. Look for this line of code. Another way that your site could trigger the HTTP error 431 is the way in which it's using cookies. For example, if you're setting lots of cookies in users' browsers, that could trigger the error. This is one of the reasons why clearing a site's cookies is one of the potential fixes. To avoid this, make sure that you're not setting too many cookies by accident. This will require digging into your site's code or hiring an expert with the qualifications to do so. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.